there, how the bonds are present between the nucleotides, it means nitrogen base pairs, sugar and phosphate groups. Now coming to the packaging of DNA. So already I told DNA is present in the nucleus, so it means in the chromatin. So DNA is a part of the chromatin. So in the chromatin, the proteins and DNA is the part, DNA are the part. So here how they are packaged. For example, you take the human genome. Human genome means haploid content of the DNA of, haploid DNA content of the human being. So that is comprises of 3.2 into 10 to the power of 9 base pairs of nucleotides. 9 base pairs of nucleotide means when you come to the measure wise, that is equivalent to 2.2 meters. So 2.2 meters length of the DNA, how it is packaged into the cell, how it is packaged into the nucleus. How it is packaged means it is said in the terms of nucleosome concept. So you see here, the nucleus is present in the eukaryotes only. In prokaryotes, there is no prominent nucleus. Okay, but the nucleo the DNA is present in the cytoplasm only. So that is in the form of genophore. How the genophore is produced means, so in prokaryotes, the DNA do not scattered in the total cell, it means total cytoplasm. It is restricted into the one site. How it is restricted into the one site means, here generally the DNA is in negative charge. Okay, but the negative charged DNA is binded with the positive charged proteins. So the positive charged proteins, when they are binded with the negative charges DNA, it make the stability of the DNA, and there are the large loops are produced. So the large loops are belongs to the genophore structure. It means here the chromatin organization is absent in prokaryotes. But whereas in eukaryotes, the chromatin organization is present, that is said in the terms of nucleosome concept, that is in the form of packaging of DNA. So first here, what is nucleosome? So nucleosome is a component, it is a combination of DNA as well as proteins, but it is meant for packing of DNA within the chromatin. Okay, you are seeing here, already I told the DNA is having the negative charge, but the negative charge DNA is wrapped with the, it means positively charged proteins. So two types of the proteins are involved for the nucleosome concept or packaging of the DNA. So histone proteins and non-histone proteins. Okay, histone proteins and non-histone proteins means they are rich of the, histone proteins are basically rich of the basic amino acids, lysine and arginine. So presence of the lysine and arginine, it acquires the positive charge. Okay, so the positive charge of the histone proteins are present. You see here, this is the diagram of the nucleosome, so core of the histone molecule. How the histone molecules are produced? You see here, this is the DNA. So the DNA is wrapped around the protein. So this is it having the negative charge and it having the positive charge. Okay, so H1 histone proteins and histone, it means different types of the H1 histone proteins are present. H1, H1B histone proteins, like histone, the 8 type of the histone proteins are come together and form as a histone aptamer. So around the histone aptamer, positive charging around the histone aptamer, the negative charge of DNA are wrapped. Then that look as a one bead. One bead means that complete structure is called as a nucleosome. So like many nucleosomes are produced by packing of DNA. Each nucleosome is approximately having the 200 base pairs length of the DNA. Okay, and after making of the nucleosomes, the nucleosomes are repeated units of the nucleosomes produce the chromatin. So the chromatin is produced. Again, the chromatin continuation formation, it form as beads of string. It means you see here, when you see the stain on the beads, like what are these beads? These beads are nucleosomes like. Okay, so they are arranged. So the chromatin plates are arranged, and the chromatin plates are highly packaged with the non-histone proteins, and they are turned into the chromosomes. Like within the chromosome, the large length of the DNA is packaged in a special manner, that is called as a nucleosome concept. But whereas in prokaryotes there is no chromatin organization, that's why only the proteins are positively charged proteins are maintaining the nucleus, maintaining the DNA at particular location, so that structure is called as a xenophore. But in eukaryotes we are talking about the chromosomes. Why they are chromosomes means chromosome is nothing but a condensed form of chromatin. At metaphase, the condensed, it means the chromatin is completely condensed and form as a thread-like structures, they are the chromosome. So this is the nucleosome concept.